Greetings, Eric Backer, New Zealand naturopath, author of Candida Crusher, formulator of the CanXida range of dietary supplements. Thank you for coming back. I'm going to do a video here, which is a bit of a sequel to the first one that I had a young man from Australia ask me, and Nick from Sydney asked me the question, where does Candida live in the body? So that's the previous video. This video I'm going to also say, what does Candida do in the body? So Candida is a yeast that lives in not everybody's body, but in many people have got Candida living there in harmony and in balance with other organisms, other kinds of yeasts and other kinds of bacteria in particular. It's a little bit like a city. Let's say pick Amsterdam, where we've got a huge, big, multicultural society. We've got people from all sorts of countries living there. We've got people from the Dutch Antilles, from Suriname living there. We might have people from America living there. We'll have guys from ladies from Spain living there, Portugal. We'll have people from Morocco, people from Australia. Heaps of different types of people live there. Tall people, skinny people, fat people, yellow people, brown people, whatever. So there's lots of people living there, and they're supposed to live in harmony, but not everybody lives in harmony. We can see what's happened, unfortunately, with a large amount of people coming into Europe at the moment, with the big Muslim influx. Whilst all Muslim people are wonderful people and peace-abiding and lovely people, we're going to get some radical extreme people in there. And of course, that's going to create a big problem. That's going to create a lot of problem. And that's what happens with Candida. If we get Candida living in harmony and in balance, it's going to be okay. It's going to be kept in check by many other kinds of bacteria and yeasts. However, if it gets the upper hand and we get a couple of these ISIS guys amongst the Candida, or terrorist kind of people, okay? Well, yeast can be a bit like that as well. It's opportunistic, right? It's parasitic. It will take from you and not give back. It will start creating a big problem because all of a sudden it's going to create a mini city for itself. Now, some people call this a biofilm. So it will really try and, you know, rev things up in the body. It causes a big problem with the immune system. That's one of the biggest things that it does. It can cause immune suppression. It can cause immune upregulation. So your immune system can take off and secrete many chemicals to try and counter the yeast infection. But what happens, unfortunately, it can create a big stress on the body. It can make the person feel quite unwell. It can push the person into many endocrine dysfunctions. I've seen many people with major yeast infection, yeast imbalance long term, develop thyroid and adrenal dysfunction for many different reasons. Too many I can go into in this video. So when you've had this problem for a long time, it causes a big stress and weakness to the body. The endocrine system becomes compromised. Everything becomes compromised, sleep and energy and libido and well-being. So all these sorts of things can happen. And then unfortunately, cortisol starts going increasingly down. The adrenals have a problem keeping up with enough cortisol supply. And then the immune system becomes weak. And then Candida really ramps up and takes off. And then you start getting bad bacteria coming on board. And because you're so weak, it's not hard to get a blasto or blastocystis or a parasite infection on top of the whole thing. So that's what Candida can do to the body. It can make you weak and sick, and it can make you vulnerable, and over time, increasingly vulnerable to more insidious and awful diseases, particularly parasitic infections, bacterial imbalances. Increasing amount of yeast can come in the body. And then what happens? The person goes to the doctor, gets pharmaceutical medications that further weaken and sicken the body. And eventually the patient comes to someone like me and they're on a cocktail of drugs. They've taken multiple rounds of antibiotics. They're very sick. They've got exhausted all their income. They've been to 50 doctors. They've gone to Dr. Google. Dr. Google couldn't cure them. And then eventually I hear about these kind of people. They're quite tough people to treat when they've had Candida for 20 or 30 years. I prefer to get hold of a patient when they've been unwell for, you know, only a short period of time, because we can turn them around quite quick. So the longer Candida has been in the body, the stronger the symptoms can be. The more they've set in, the harder they can be to shift. I've yet to see a case that doesn't improve, but I have seen plenty of patients that aren't willing to do what it takes to improve. So that's the big difference there. So I hope that gives you a little bit of an insight on what Candida does to the body. It's like any other kind of imbalance. It's best corrected at the onset rather than down the track. A small problem fixed now can save a hell of a lot of problems down the track. So think about that. If you are new to this YouTube channel, please check out my book, Candida Crusher, and please have a look at my CanXida range of supplements, which were designed for people, you know, with yeast imbalance ranging from very mild to moderate to severe to extreme. Product range is used successfully with people with parasites, with small intestinal bacterial overgrowth, irritable bowel syndrome, and many conditions like that. So I hope that answers some of the questions on what does Candida do to the body. Don't forget to click on the link below if you haven't got my report, and please subscribe. Thanks for tuning in.